Hey, what's up, you guys? Putting a trailer hitch on your GMC Terrain can take you to some really cool places, like biking, camping, or even towing a U-Haul trailer just about anywhere in North America. Let's go ahead and break that down.
You'll need the tools seen here to complete this installation.
So we're gonna prep the underbody of our vehicle for the hitch. We're gonna start by removing this panel right here on the bottom of the bumper. It's held in by two clips. We're just gonna pull up on the tab on the back and it'll allow us to pull it down. And we'll do it on the other side as well. Now that we have those two clips out, we're just gonna pull down and we will not be reinstalling this. So behind this panel, we have two attachment points for our hitch. Depending on your model of terrain, it could either be a weld nut or it could be a carriage bolt. So when you look down here, you'll see these two holes. We do not have a weld nut on ours, so we'll be using a carriage bolt and block, and we will be using a fish wire technique to bring those into place. So we're gonna start by taking our fish wire and we're gonna put it into our attachment hole. Now it won't be able to come out of this square hole right next to our attachment hole since it's not big enough for our block. So we're gonna push it all the way out to the end of our frame and it will come out right here at the end of the frame over the exhaust. Now we'll attach our bolt and block to our fish wire and then we'll go ahead and pull it through. And then we'll repeat on the other hole. And we'll leave both of our fish wires on. Now on the passenger side, on the side of the frame, we have two more attachment points here and here. Now there may be bolts in place right there. If there are, just go ahead and remove those. Ours doesn't have it. Now those two holes are identical on the driver's side. And with nothing in place, we're ready to bring our hitch into place. We're gonna use our U-Haul exclusive hitch jack. If you don't have one, we recommend getting an extra set of hands as this hitch is a little heavy. Now before we raise it all the way, we're gonna take our fish wires and we're gonna pull it through these holes in the middle of the hitch. That way when we raise it, it won't hit our bolts back into the frame. So to help you guys see a little better on what we're doing, we went ahead and lowered our exhaust. It's not required for your install. But now that we have everything lined up, we're ready to bring our bolts into place on the driver's side. We just have two weld nuts and two bolts. These bolts come with conical tooth washers. We want to make sure that the teeth are facing the hitch on those. And we'll repeat on the passenger side. Now in our two middle bolts, we're going to remove our fish wires and install our provided flange nuts. With all of our bolts in place, we're ready to tighten and torque all of them to the manufacturer's specification. We'll be using a 19 millimeter socket for all of our bolts. With our hitch installed, we went ahead and pulled our vehicle down onto level ground to show you some important measurements for your hitch accessories. This is a 2-inch receiver. From the pinhole to the edge of the bumper is 3.5 inches. And from the ground to the top of the inside of the receiver is 15 inches. This will help you determine the length, rise, and drop for your hitch accessories, such as a bike rack and a cargo carrier. So that wraps up our install and our video. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions about this product, or if you'd like to schedule an installation with a U-Haul Hitch professional, you can visit your closest U-Haul Hitch Center, or you can visit us online at uhaulhitches.com. Thank you.